This next gentleman is a really needs no introduction. Just one of those guys that steps out, steps ahead of the rest of the pack. A great leader, a great teacher, a friend of all of us. Our football coach, Mr. Hal Chauncey. Hal?
Kidding and throwing that pass. That was a pass of Robles. And after the game, they invited all of us, all the guys over to a dance in the gym. And they provided girls, you know, for the guys to dance with. And of course, all the quarterbacks and everything, they dressed quickly and got out. They got the real nice looking girls. And Ron Mick was always very fastidious. And he was the last one out of the locker room. So he got a gal that was about 5 foot tall and outweighed him by 30 pounds. And he pushed her around the floor. And he kept thinking, the coach always said, now we got to say something nice to the girl when we get through. And he thought and thought and thought. And finally, the only thing he could think of saying, he took her back to her friends and said, you know, for a fat girl, she don't sweat very much. Jay was telling a story, and this cop stopped this guy for speeding, walked up alongside the car and said, what's your name? He says, Fred. I said, Fred what? Just plain Fred. Now, what's your last name? He says, I don't have a last name. You don't have a last name? No, he says, I lost it. You lost your last name? How'd you lose your last name? Well, stay with me now. When I was born, my name was Fred Ding-a-ling. You can imagine the rash I took all through school with a name like that. He said, finally I graduated, got out of school, went to college, got my degree, went to medical school, got my MD. Then I was known as Fred Ding-a-ling, MD. Then I decided, well, I'll be a dentist too. So he went to dentistry school and got his DDS. Then I was known as Fred Ding-a-ling, MD, DDS. Then I started messing around with my secretary and she gave me a VD. Then I was known as Fred Ding-a-ling, MD, DDS with VD. Then the AMA found out I had VD and took away my MD. Then I was on Fred Ding-a-ling DDS with VD. Then the Dental Association found out I had VD and took away my DDS. Then I just noticed Fred Ding-a-ling with VD. Then the VD took away my ding-a-ling, so now I'm just on Fred. Well, you don't know how long I have wished for this reunion. Been over 50 years since I've seen most of you guys and gals, and Kathy and I are really looking forward to this. So I want to thank the committee for setting this thing up. They did a great job, a lot of hard work, and we really enjoyed it. I think everyone now knows that Mr. Nyman passed away last month. He attended a lot of reunions, and he would have loved to have been at this one to see how how well everyone had done, and all of his hard work really paid off. How many people here went into education to teaching? One, two, three. He would have been really proud of all your people, particularly. Well, it's down memory lane, you know, tonight, and all the stories that went on. It's too bad we can't have all those taped and put on the website. It would have been a riot. How lucky we were when we came to Hawthorne, and Kathy and I came to Hawthorne in 1948, and got the job at Gunga Din Club. You realize how lucky you were. And how lucky you were to live in Hawthorne, who was really a kid-friendly town. You know, if you look back, we had the great park program on the park afternoon and Saturdays. They had the Gunga Din Club that the kids built. They had the ball games at the park at night. And then they had the Hawthorne Youth Camp that many of you helped build. So it was really a kid-friendly community. And the cap covered it, our first faculty meeting. We got together and we had had practically no varsity football coaching experience. But you know, the kids didn't hold it against us. They finally realized it, though, I think. Anyway, Cap mentioned 13 teachers. I think there's, I don't know how many of them are still left. Cap, do you?
You and I.
And Pfeiffer.